This is Texas Tech Football. Texas Tech football is embarking on a new era. The excitement is building to a crescendo as the Red Raiders prepare to take the Big 12 and the nation by storm. Tech football ushers in the 21st century with a new look, a new attitude, and a new coaching staff. Taking the lead and holding the reins is head football coach Mike Leach. A veteran of offensive leadership, Leach has proven time and again that his offense can put points on the scoreboard. As offensive coordinator at Oklahoma, Leach took a struggling offense and turned it into one of the best in the nation. In a single season, he resurrected an offense that was 11th in the Big 12 in 1998 to first in 1999, from 101st in the nation to 11th. Last season, his Sooners ranked 8th in the nation in scoring with 36.8 points per game and set 6 Big 12 and 17 school records. At the University of Kentucky, Leach masterminded the Kentucky Air Raid offense that was one of the most explosive in Southeastern Conference history. The Leach-led attack produced more than 500 yards total offense in 7 games, including a school record 801 yards against Louisville in 1998. While at Oklahoma and Kentucky, Coach Leach produced two outstanding quarterbacks that gained both conference and national honors. Oklahoma quarterback Josh Heupel was named Big 12 Offensive Newcomer of the Year, and Kentucky quarterback Tim Couch was consensus All-American and the first selection in the 1999 NFL Draft. With a new offensive attack at the ready, the Red Raiders must also maintain a strong line of defense that can contribute its own share of points. Enter defensive coordinator Greg McMackin, who knows what it takes to build a tough defense. While with the Seattle Seahawks, McMackin's defense led the NFL in forced turnovers with 41 and finished second in sacks with 51. The Seahawks also set an NFL record by scoring 14 defensive touchdowns in a single season. McMackin coached 10 all-pro players who helped set franchise records such as fewest yards allowed in a game, sacks in a game with 9, and 5 interceptions in a game. Then it was on to Hawaii, where McMackin led the Rainbow Warriors to the best turnaround in NCAA history, going from 0-12 to 9-4. In 1999, Hawaii broke 25 school records and ranked first in their conference with 34 forced turnovers, 17 interceptions, and 17 fumble recoveries. During his tenure at the University of Miami, McMackin directed a Hurricane defense that ranked number one in the nation in pass defense, total defense, and scoring defense. At Miami, he coached Lombardi Award winner Warren Sapp, National Defensive Player of the Year Ray Lewis, and 6 first-team consensus All-Americans. Assistant head coach and special teams coordinator Manny Matsakis brings an exciting blend of offensive experience to the Red Raiders staff. Last year, as Wyoming's offense coordinator, he took an offense that had previously been ranked 7th in the Mountain West Conference and produced a balanced attack that led the Mountain West in total offense while ranking 2nd in passing, rushing, and scoring offense versus conference opponents. At Emporia State, Matsakis generated the same success, coaching a team that set 22 NCAA offensive records, 65 school marks, and finished with a number 10 Division II ranking in 1998. The previous season, his team led the nation in total offense and scoring. Under Matsakis' guidance, Brian Shea received the 1998 Division II Player of the Year honors and ended his career as the all-time NCAA leader in rushing, scoring, and all-purpose yards. During his tenure at Hofstra University, Matsakis directed an offense that ranked number one in the nation in passing, scoring, and total offense. At Hofstra, he recruited and coached 3 current NFL starters, Wayne Krabet of the New York Jets, Dave Fiore of the San Francisco 49ers, and Domingo Graham of the San Diego Chargers. Offensive line coach Robert Anai was an all-conference lineman on a Brigham Young team that won the 1984 national championship. He played on 4 WAC title teams and participated in 6 Holiday Bowls, 4 as a player and 2 as a coach. Anai served as the director of the Student Athlete Center at BYU before coming to Tech. A name synonymous with success in Texas high school football, running backs coach Art Briles joins the Red Raider staff after serving as the head coach for 11 years at powerhouse Stephenville High School. A brief list of accolades begins with 4 state championship titles, a team that set the all-time national high school record for total offense, teams that hold the third and fourth highest all-time offensive totals, and a 1999 state championship team that totaled over 7,000 yards offense. A new face with a familiar name takes his turn at Texas Tech. Wide receivers coach Sonny Dykes returns to his alma mater after stops at the University of Kentucky and the University of Louisiana Monroe. An offensive specialist, Dykes coached Kentucky All-American tight end James Whalen, who set the NCAA record for most receptions by a tight end. The Red Raider defensive line is in the veteran hands of Ron Harris, who led Glendale Community College to the National Junior College National Championship in 1988. Harris has made coaching stops at Northern Arizona, Utah, Navy, and Western New Mexico University. Dana Holgerson took the Wingate University passing game to new heights last season, guiding the team to several South Atlantic Conference offensive records. In 1997, he helped lead Mississippi College to an American Southwest Conference title. Holgerson now turns his attention to coaching the Texas Tech inside receivers. Linebackers coach Ruffin McNeil has put together championship defenses at many stops in his career. He helped Appalachian State to Southern Conference titles in 1991 and 1995. He also guided Fresno State to a WAC Tri-Championship and participated in Clemson's 1986 Atlantic Coast Conference crown. From 1989 to 1996, McNeil coached in six NCAA 1-2A playoff games. Brian Norwood brings an exciting combination of playing and coaching experience to the Tech staff. A defensive back from Hawaii, he played professionally for the Calgary Stampede in 1989. He has since coached at the University of Arizona, Richmond University, and the United States Naval Academy. Norwood worked with head coach Mike Leach in Japan and teams up with him again here at Texas Tech to take charge of the Red Raider defensive backs. The game plan is in motion. Coach Leach has put together one of the best and brightest coaching staffs in the nation. Everyone is working together to bring about a new and exciting era of Texas Tech football, an era that will set the precedent of how football will be played in Texas and across the nation. There has never been a better time to be a Texas Tech Red Raider. Come together.
Can you hear the roar of the crowd? Can you feel the excitement? Can you taste victory? Y'all ready for this? It's almost here, and victory is within our reach. There's nothing quite like the excitement that Red Raider football brings. For 50 years, the Texas Tech Red Raiders have brought that excitement and winning tradition to fans at Jones Stadium. Now it's time to raise the bar and have facilities that both fans and the Red Raiders deserve. Introducing plans for the Jones SBC Stadium expansion and renovation. Beginning in 2000, the first stage of construction will expand and improve ADA seating and restroom and concession areas. Stage 2, scheduled to begin in 2001, will see the addition of an exclusive area for Red Raider Club members and football fans, the Red Raider Stadium Club.
Our fans, alumni, students, and our community have asked for a total commitment to have a football program that can be competitive at the highest levels. Texas Tech has made that commitment to have a program that is second to none. The renovation and expansion of Jones SBC Stadium, spurred by a generous donation from SBC Communications, will ensure first-class football facilities, the best in college football. The Red Raider Stadium Club is your way to participate in the stadium renovation, while at the same time assuring yourself, your friends, and your family more excitement and fun at Texas Tech football games than ever before.
When the renovated and expanded Jones SBC Stadium is completed, a new day for Red Raider football fans will dawn, the opening of the Red Raider Stadium Club. Fans will view the game at a whole new level in the Red Raider Stadium Club. Located on the first tier of Jones SBC Stadium's new luxury suite and seating area, the Red Raider Stadium Club will offer extraordinary comfort in both indoor and outdoor seating areas. All Red Raider Stadium Club seat holders will have access to an exclusive 16,000 square foot entertainment area. Until now, fans have never had the opportunity to meet their friends and enjoy Red Raider games in the comfort of an ultra-modern club facility. And the Red Raider Stadium Club is an exclusive area for entertaining clients and business associates. Take advantage of the festive atmosphere in the Stadium Club and be a part of hard-hitting Texas Tech football action. Red Raider football history will be made at the kickoff of the first game in the exciting new Jones SBC Stadium. You want to be in the Red Raider Stadium Club as the crowd roars when the first Red Raider touchdown is scored. The Red Raider Stadium Club will offer theater-sized chairback seats in both exclusive indoor and outdoor areas. Exclusive amenities and benefits of the Stadium Club include spectacular view of the field, priority parking, theater-sized chairback seats, complimentary soft drinks and popcorn, variety of food and drink services available, TV monitors, halftime and post-game statistical service, multiple elevator and escalator services, complimentary game program, and priority option to rent the Stadium Club for private use. Seating in the Red Raider Stadium Club is secured by making an annual tax-deductible contribution to the Red Raider Club. This is the first commitment to bring Jones SBC Stadium seating to a donor-based system. This positive change provides tangible benefits to Red Raider Club donors. Starting with the 2002 football season, all priority seating will require Red Raider Club membership contributions. As a member of the Big 12 Conference, Texas Tech is the last university in the conference to move to a donor-based seating system. It's time for Texas Tech athletics to step up and remain competitive with the other Big 12 universities.
The Texas Tech Athletics Department has made the commitment to make our football program among the best in the nation. Now is your opportunity to be a part of the excitement. With your support, we can be second to none.
Be a part of the inaugural year of the exciting new Red Raider Stadium Club and sign up as a charter member. Until July 10th, 2000, you may become a charter member at the Red Raider Stadium Club at the seating level of your choice with the following guaranteed benefits for the term of your commitment. Guaranteed priority seat selection. Non-escalating Red Raider Club annual donation. Guaranteed Red Raider Stadium Club seat pricing. season ticket discounts based upon Red Raider Club donation commitment turns. Return your membership agreement today and be a part of Red Raider football history. For more information and to reserve the best seat in town, call the Red Raider Club at 742-1196 or 762-2000 or visit our website at www.texastech.com.